This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Plied. It is the last video in this series, and I'm kind of sad. I'm sad and excited. I'm excited to see what you think about this series and see yarns that you make. This technique is called looped, and I was going to do it with just one yarn, but I thought, let's go out with a bang. Let's do it with three yarns at the same time. So I've never done this before. It's an idea I had about creating a yarn that's kind of like a vine or a garland that just has like loop, 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 loop. And not even a boucle. It's more like creating loops like this that go all the way down the yarn. So it kind of reminds me of the shagged that we did, but you don't have to cut anything. It reminds me of the boucle, but you don't have to ply it back on itself. It reminds me of locked, but we're not adding anything to it. So anyway, I have 1, 2, 3 yarns and 1 plying thread. We are going to tie all of these in a knot. Make sure the thread's nice and secure. And I already know we're not going to make very much yardage with this because my bobbin's so small and this is going to be really bulky. So you can see it. Okay. So I'm going to bring my tension back down to start. Now I'm holding all three yarns in one hand and I'm plying them with the plying thread. But since this yarn is going to probably be used as a ready-to-wear scarf or something, I don't need a ton of yardage. I'm definitely not going to be knitting this or crocheting this. So That's a loop. I guess I could decide if I want the loops to have twist in them or if I want them to be separate. I think my original idea was separate. So it kind of reminds me of the twists technique, but rather than making twists, I'm making loops. So I am noticing that these yarns have a lot of twist in them, which is causing them to twist, and I want these loops to stay pretty open. I'm going to loop this yarn, take my plying thread, wrap it around the loop to secure it a couple times, why not? And then do a little bit of a twist, and here's my loop. And I like it with 3 because I can spread that apart. However, this is not creating the loop that I want it to create. I want, like, see how this is like a leaf? I want to create leaves back and forth. So let's keep working with it and see what happens. So here's another leaf. I'm going to take my plying thread and wrap it around the base of this leaf twice and do a little spin, make another leaf, wrap my plying thread around the base of it twice, a little spin, make another leaf, wrap my yarn around the base of it twice, keeping it nice and secure. There's no gaps in my thread at all. And keep going. There's another leaf. Wrap my yarn around the base of it twice and a little twist. Another leaf. Wrap my yarn around the base twice and twist. So here's what we have so far. And I guess that's what I'm looking for. Maybe if I were to set it, and get this twist out of these. It would hang open like loops better. But I am going for like a vine. Like imagine this in green. I think, you know what? I think that's unique enough. Is that unique enough for you guys? I don't think I've seen anything like this before. I just don't want it to be like, well, that's just twisted with less twist, or it's just shagged without breaking it, or it's just this. Wrap. I guess the technique is different because we are wrapping the thread around twice. Yeah, that's something that we have not done yet. Cool. So there's our first bit of yardage. Let's bring that up on the bobbin. Wonder if making smaller loops would make them. Yeah, I think that making smaller loops would give them that look that I want. Wrap, wrap, spin. Make a little loop. 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 Wrap, wrap, spin. Wrap, spin. I like this. I like this a lot. Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted. Cool. And to think I was only going to use one yarn to make this instead of three. See, this is where the party's at. This is a party on a bobbin. Okay, make a little loop. Wrap, wrap. After I wrap, I bring it down and do a little twist. Make a little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Create a tangle. Make a little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop. I probably don't need to say it the whole time, but it keeps me in a rhythm. Loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop. Wrap, wrap, twist. Nice. I like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. And I've never seen anyone else spin yarn like this before. Doesn't mean no one ever has, but it's definitely not common. Wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop. Wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop. Wrap, wrap. Twist, loop, wrap, wrap, twist, loop, twist, loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Oh, I'm almost out of one of my yarns, and I think that's what I'm going to call it done. I'm shocked how fast this technique goes. When you get into your rhythm, and you could separate all these little loops too. And I think making it with multiple yarns just makes it like super full and fun. Fun, fun, fun. I mean, at this point, a bobbin is really kind of pointless. Like, I don't even know. There's loops caught all over the place. Where does it even go? Where does it even fit? I have no idea what I'm doing. Okay, let's wrap it up. But it is like a vine. I wanted it to be like leaves on a vine. You could make a yarn like this using much thinner yarns, like green, and then ply it with a yarn spun with clusters of purple beads, and it would look like a rainforest plant. Like leaves with clusters of beads in it that you could ply it. That would be so cool. My bobbin isn't even turning anymore. I think this is the fullest bobbin ever. But I'm determined to finish. One, two, three. We'll do a little bit more and then we'll be done. And then I'll take it off so you can see what it looks like. A little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop, wrap, wrap, twist. Make a little loop, wrap, twist. This is really fast. Wrap, twist. This is really fun. Wrap, twist. Hope you're having fun too. Wrap, twist. Almost out of yardage. Wrap, twist. Wrap, twist. Gonna go out of the frame because I'm almost done with this black, and so I'm just gonna ply to the end of the black like this. I just plied them all together, and now that I'm just at two whites and my plying thread, I'm gonna tie them in a really secure knot, and we are gonna take this off the bobbin. And see. Oh, I only had like 8 inches left of another one, too. Let's take this off the I'm just gonna take the whole thing out. Wow, I can't believe we fit that much on this bobbin. That's impressive. Very impressive. What a fun technique. I mean, I've never done this before. I was just like, I want to create a vine. Okay, so now let me tie, these are the ends. So I'm just going to tie these in a knot. And drape it around my neck so you can see what it would look like as a cowl. There's another cute. So cute. I love it. What if it had feathers in it? And you can set it and open all these loops up. Wear it with a wool pea coat in the wintertime. I love it.